everybody. Welcome to Leia the Untouched Gamer Show. This is my show because I'm holding the controller.
And I quit. I'm not doing this. I'm under duress. I refuse. We've destroyed multiple videos of XCOM. My XCOM game is kaput, gone forever. I got to start over completely from scratch. All the recordings of everything we've made in the past few weeks are unusable because Leia and I have been sick and there's just constant coughing in all the videos. And then we start Chrono Trigger and the game freezes and the recording freezes and Leia's saying inappropriate stuff on the stream. And so we got to start over and we've been at this for so long and we can't use anything. And I'm just done with it. I'm just done with it. She can carry the show all by herself. I'm not even going to pay attention. I'm not going to read her walkthrough. I don't
care. You're not going to read me her walkthrough?
Nope. I'm going to talk about is I'm going to talk about I finally figured out Starwar. So, now I have to go through all this again. So, Starwar is there's two movies in the 80s, Starwar Hop and Starwar Umpire, about like space fighting. Nobody's ever seen them, but they were kind of popular in their own little crowds anyway. And then a whole bunch of like fan-made movies were attempted to be made, and there's like there's the Starwar curse, where if you ever try to make a movie past the second movie, it just gets ruined. Like the movie they tried to make for the third one, which was actually the sixth one, for some reason, because Hop was 4 and Umpire was 5. And it's called Star Wars Hop because they're hopping from star to star or planet to planet. And it's called Star Wars Umpire because, I don't know, was there baseball in that one? I think there was a baseball game in it. Anyway, like space baseball or something. She's fighting the same. Last time you fought these guys, it froze the entire game. So, just saying. Well, but so I finally figured out the canon of the Star Wars movies. What happens is there's George Lucas Skywalker is the hero, or he's supposed to be, and then there's Hansel only is another hero, and they're trying to rescue Princess Lando Calrissian, and so they're fighting against the Empire, which has like or no not the Empire it's the Galactic Federation. So they're fighting against the Galactic Federation, who's led by the Sloth Lords. And the Sloth Lords are really powerful, really slow, obviously, but really powerful. So the Galactic Federation is just unbeatable because they have this big, giant space station that can blow up planets. So,
yes, it didn't freeze. Okay, good.
So George Lucas Skywalker has to rescue the princess and try to defeat the Galactic Federation. Only problem is he can't. So in the first movie, they sort of kind of win against the Galactic Federation, right? But in the second movie, the Galactic Federation just puts down the resistance and sends them all packing and cuts off George Lucas Skywalker's hand and all this stuff. And he also finds out that he's actually Prince of the Galactic Federation and he's supposed to inherit the kingdom, because the king is his dad. Darkness Invader is the name of his king. Anyway, so then what happens is there's this third movie, and in the third movie, they basically do the exact same thing that they did in the first movie to beat the Galactic Federation. But there's a whole bunch of teddy bears helping them. And see, that's what really happens in the universe of Star Wars is that third movie, the events of the third movie, happen up until about halfway through the movie. And then Hans Zimmerman gets frozen in carbonite, and is betrayed, And George Lucas Skywalker is defeated.
So where do I need to go now? In time? Huh?
Talk to the guru. He'll tell you. Yeah, figure it out.
Okay, talk to the guru.
Yeah, you're going walkthrough list because this is important. Okay? So the rest of the movies that people have tried to make about Star Wars make absolutely no sense whatsoever. The third movie, with the Ewoks and teddy bears destroying the Galactic Federation, that's just impossible nonsense. I mean, you have teddy bears with sticks beating Imperial stormtroopers and giant AT-ATs. Yeah, that could not happen. So that part of the story is a defeated George Lucas Skywalker is telling a fake version of events to his nieces and nephews, Hans Zimmerman and Princess Lando's kids. So his nieces and nephews, it's like Winnie the Pooh-style stories about his fight against the Galactic Federation. So he tells them that they defeated the Galactic Federation with the help of teddy bears. Well, obviously, that's not the case. The Galactic Federation's still around, and all this, in the end of the third movie, is fabricated a made-up happy ending to an otherwise unhappy story that the Galactic Federation... Although it's not really an unhappy story, because if the Galactic Federation had fallen, then there'd be a huge power vacuum that the Hutts would have come up, and other various warring factions. So the Galactic Federation has to keep order, of course. So it's George Lucas Skywalker telling his nieces and nephews this fanciful story of how we beat the Galactic Federation with teddy bears. So that's why the third movie is like it is. It starts all of a sudden being unreliable narrator George. I'll just start calling George Lucas Skywalker just Luke for short. So Luke's telling his kids or his nieces and nephews.
So the guru said something about the wings of time.
Yeah, you need to go to the end of time, or not the end of time, the future. All right. So Protodome, Banger Dome. There's a time machine in the future. Go get it. All right. Nope. So
let me see if I can remember which one to go in.
There you go. Something like that.
So we have to find the wings of time.
Yep. So then we've got to explain the other movies in the Star Wars series. Because they made these other movies that are called the prequels that make absolutely no sense at all and can't possibly be real. So again, we've got Luke telling a story of things that he has absolutely no knowledge of to his nieces and nephews, and Luke's a bad storyteller, which is why he tells this silly, absurd story about the Clone Wars. The Clone Wars is something that he heard about from his uncle, but Ben Kenobi never really tells him anything that happened. And Luke's dad never really tells him anything that's happened. So Luke's nieces and nephews, they want to know what happened. Yeah, you're going down to that one, so you have to go through there. They want to know what happened. He doesn't know what happened, so he just makes stuff up. So he makes up this stupid imaginary character. You don't have to beat him. You just race. Or you can walk. Either way. It doesn't matter. If you walk, you might have to get into battles. Yeah, so. So in episode... Well. Yeah, they fooled you. So in episode one, the Phantom Menace, that's Luke telling this story to his little kids, or his little nieces and nephews, and they're real young at the time he's telling this story. And they're really into, like, racing and stuff like that. So he incorporates, like... this weird idea of pod racing into the story, and they've you know, their favorite guys are R2-D2 and C-3PO, and he tries to, you know, put those in the story, and it's all just nonsense. And he makes his father, Anakin, out to be, you know, this little kid pod racer, and he makes up this whole story behind it, everything. But it's all just made up nonsense by Luke. He's telling this story to his nieces and nephews, and that's why none of it makes sense. And he also has this stupid character named Jar Jar and this is because Jar Jar is the favorite word of his like infant niece that's like 1 year old, and that's the word she says, Jar Jar, you know, like little baby talk. And so whenever he says it, she giggles. And so he's made up this character where he can make faces and do silly things to amuse infant children. So that's why episode one. And then episode two and three are the stories that he tells later after his nieces and nephews have grown up and they're a little bit older and they're getting a little bit, you know, angsty and they're annoyed at the world and having to go to school and everything. So he tells this story. So kind of as a cautionary tale, he makes Anakin out to be this, you know, moody. And of course, Luke's niece is, you know, going through, you know, some sort of relationship stuff. So he has to work in relationship stuff into the story to try to make it accessible to his nieces and nephews. But again, it's just really bad storytelling.
Rocket roll multi-attack.
So that explains episodes 1, 2, and 3. None of the stuff ever happened. The Galactic Federation wins in movie 3. The little Ewok things don't even help. You know, it's all a wash. I mean, we can tell that all the end of the third movie is made up because they end up just blowing up the Death Star again. You know, there's no way they could have done that twice. I mean, once maybe, you know, but doing it twice, that just, it's lazy storytelling, you know, by George Lucas Skywalker, that he's like, oh, well, we just blew up the Death Star again. You know, obviously he's just, you know, Luke sitting there telling his nieces and nephews, just, you know, this nonsense story just to keep them entertained. So then we have the question of these other movies. Okay. So there's these other movies called like the Force Awakens and Rogue One and Solo, all these other movies that are afterwards that are obviously not Luke telling the story, right? Because Luke is portrayed as just an absolute jerk, and the rest of the movies, they again make absolutely no sense, but in a much different way. They're just over the top, like they're some sort of summer blockbuster action movie instead of like his storytelling. Those movies, Rogue One, Solo, and the Last Jedi, The Force Awakens, all those movies, those are movies
made. Access.
I think that's where you need to go, is the sewer access. Those are movies made in the Star Wars universe. So as a stormtrooper is sitting out, hanging out in the movie theater in the second Death Star, which was never destroyed, well, then he's going to kick back. He's going to kick back, and he's going to watch The Force Awakens. Right. And it's got this fanciful idea. And there's always this idea of, oh, the Galactic Federation is corrupt and we're going to stand up against it, because everybody has those feelings within a civilization. But nobody's going to try to, you know, rise up against the Galactic Federation. But they will watch movies that have that idea, you know. And of course, the Sloth Lords, they don't care that they make movies about that, you know, because they've got their power. They've got, you know, their, you know, infinite space magic, which that's another thing. See, Luke never was trained as a Jedi. Ben died before he could. He left Yoda, didn't finish his training before Yoda could ever explain to him what the Force really was. So Luke, with no training whatsoever as a Jedi, has no idea how the Force works. So when his nieces and nephews ask him how the Force works, Luke's a bad storyteller. He makes up this nonsense about microscopic space bugs in your blood. And so that's all just in his head. None of that's real. Obviously, the Sloth Lords know how to use real space magic a whole lot better than... So all of a sudden, the entire canon of the Starwar franchise falls into place when we understand that some of the stories, even like the Ewok movies, right? Okay, so the Ewok movies is, again, Luke telling his nieces and nephews fun stories about the Ewoks, because that's obviously their favorite characters, you know, and these little, these little 2 and 3 year olds, anything that makes sounds is going to make those things attack you. These little 2 and 3 year olds just love the Ewoks, you know, like I did when I was a little kid, right? We liked the Ewok movies. So that's just Luke telling that story. It explains the Christmas special, okay? The Christmas special is apparently George Lucas Skywalker just got, drunk at a Christmas party one time and started telling stories about Chewbacca and Han Solo and stuff that made no sense whatsoever, you know, in some sort of, you know, drunken haze. It's just, you know, he's bad storytelling. And then the more action-oriented Star Wars stuff, the Star Wars video games, or obviously all the Lego Star Wars stuff exists within the Star Wars universe as IP. That's an intellectual, they've, you know, because the failed rebellion, people still have this idea of, oh man, you know, because they romanticize it and everything. So they started making movies about it the same way we have movies about the Wild West, but we don't actually live like the Wild West. Or we have, movies about, that have actual revolutionaries in them, but none of us really want a revolution. We just, you know, the movie escapism. So that explains all of the Star Wars movies in the entire canon. We can now understand that we have the two that actually happened, Star Wars Hop and Star Wars Umpire, episodes 4 and 5. And then we get into the area of Luke, George Lucas Skywalker, just being a bad storyteller. And then we get into the area of within the Star Wars universe, stormtroopers are watching these summer blockbuster action movies with really hokey acting and, terrible acting, terrible writing, and just tons of special effects budgets, you know, and that's the later movies. So all of a sudden, the Star Wars canon just falls into place. I finally figured it out. I understand the entire art form of, certain art creators, all of their stuff exists within a shared universe. I think Tarantino does the same thing. Some of his movies are movies inside some of his other movies, like the universe in which these movies take place.
They would put what looked like a save point out.
And save points make noise, do
and
they
save
not?
Save point make noise.
Okay,
and then
so
the save
anything
point,
that makes
and the
noise.
Save point disappear.
Yeah, so anything that makes noise will make those guys attack you. I did say that. So I'm just real happy to now, you know, be able to wrap my mind around and explain to people why midichlorians is mentioned in episode 1. Why Jar Jar Binks exists. We can now watch episode 1 and sit back and realize, oh, possibly senile, aging Luke Skywalker telling this story to his, toddler nieces and nephews. Or he can sit back and watch the Force Awakens and go, oh, this is what stormtroopers watch for entertainment on their break. That puts it into perspective. I've been trying to figure out those movies for a while. If you haven't, if you're not familiar with the Starwar canon, the Starwar movies, you should check them out. They're probably available on like on Netflix or something. The original ones. I gotta go around and press the switch. The switch is right there. So, see that gap in the hallway? That's a gap that you can walk through. You can get there. Trust me. It'll happen. You can get there. Wiggle it around. Go up and down a little bit. Get there. You gotta be in the right spot. You gotta be lined up in the right spot. There you go. So that's the bit that I had prepared. That's all I got. How was it, Leia?
I think it was pretty good. I mean, if you don't want to watch the Star Wars prequels, if you don't want to watch The Phantom Menace, you can always just watch Ben-Hur instead.
See, I didn't know that. I'd never seen Ben-Hur. But Leia showed me The Phantom Menace... large portions of it are shot for shot remake of like the pod races are like shot for shot remake of the chariot races in Ben-Hur, which I had no idea. I'd never seen Ben-Hur.
Oh, and big portions of the plot, like
big portions of the plot as well. Yeah,
like Ben-Hur, the fact that Ben-Hur is a slave,
and Annie was a slave.
Uh-huh.
Ridiculous that they made. Yeah.
I'm not gonna open those chests because it makes noise. Sir Crawley. Okay.
All right, so take him down. But for anyone that is curious, I did get OpenXCOM working, so I will be returning back to the XCOM playthrough. Ooh, I'll just have to kind of start over. And OpenXCOM is a little bit different than the version of XCOM that I was using off Steam. I mean, they're the same game, but OpenXCOM...
Oh, do ethers? Really, what do ethers do?
They heal magic points. Okay. Attack points, whatever. Tonic, or mid-tonic kills you for 200, so you want to use a mid-tonic on that. Yeah. There you go. And then you want to hit him just as hard as you possibly can. Robo tackle.
Boom! Yeah! Oh, I think that did it.
He's kind of a pushover.
He's a caterpillar. Mm. Yay!
It's very unlikely that we'll be returning to recording any Minecraft. That's just cumbersome because we play Minecraft on our phones, and the recording utility on my phone is cumbersome. And then I can only record my screen, you know, can't record Leia's screen. And we're definitely not returning to...
Minecraft land.
Minecraft. And we're definitely not returning to recording Speedy Egbert.
Oh, come on!
Well, we're also definitely not returning to recording
you know, jumpy shoot man. Unless you want to play Mega Man X?
No.
Okay, then. Okay. Metroid?
No.
No, see? There we go. But right now, I think our plan is to do Chrono Trigger and Final Fantasy kind of...
Just kind of alternating.
Alternating. We do plan on going through as many, at least up through Final Fantasy VII. I don't have a copy of Final Fantasy VII, but once we get there, there's one over there
that says Final Fantasy X.
Yeah, that's Final Fantasy X. Yeah, we'll do that one after VII. I doubt we'll do VIII, and I doubt we'll do IX. But we'll probably go all the way through 6, 7, and then straight to 10. We're not going to do 3. We'll do 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 10.
All right. Here's the switch that the frogs were.
Oh, you can open that chest now. You're Sir Crawley's defeated. There you go.
Ooh, I got a bolt sword.
Yeah. Yeah, don't worry. Just go up. That ladder. Mm-hmm. You might want to equip the bolt sword. Or is that where you came down?
I have no idea.
Okay, well, equip the bolt sword. Ooh,
bolt sword is actually worse for him.
Huh, weird. Okay, well, then just keep on going. But of course, Link to the Past randomizer is definitely something that I'll do.
Yeah, but they showed me the frogs about to push the button. I think you're supposed to complete this bridge.
Okay, do what you're going to do. Okay. I think that's just a shorter way to get back, though.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure that's the shortcut to get back.
Okay.
So it makes it shorter to go back the way you came. There you go. But yeah, a Link to the Past randomizer will continue to be a thing. Chess will probably, I'll probably do...
Oh, I don't think I've been here yet.
Chess is hard to do because I cannot keep commentary and pay attention to recording and play chess, at least in that time form. I might do some 10-minute games, but I'm not really good enough with chess to stream chess. That was more kind of a one-off in favor of the World Chess Championships, but I did like doing it.
There's one of those guys.
They're called News.
New.
But yeah, XCOM. We will return to our Civilization playthrough. Because we still have that saved.
Yeah.
Right? We will return to that. I'm probably done with Master of Orion since I did post up the world record speed run for 100% of Master of Orion. So I'm probably not going to revisit that. Not unless somebody bests my time, which I haven't looked on the site or anything. But if I find out that somebody has done better than me, then I'll sit down and try to do it, you know, try to beat it. Because if somebody goes through the effort of beating my time, then I will do them the honor. What? What's your
question?
Scratch
his back? No. Okay. I was trying to get behind him. Oh, there we go.
You can walk up. You can walk up. No, you're walking down. That's the down button.
Gets around.
Nope. No, it doesn't. No. Where you were earlier... Where you were earlier when I said you can walk up.
Okay.
If you had pressed the up button at that time, that would have been the time to have gone up in response to me saying you can go up. But you went down quite a lot. So go back to where you were standing. And I said, okay, go left, go left, go left. nope, nope. Go left, 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 left. Okay.
Oh.
Nope. Up. Straight up the middle. Straight up the middle. Straight up the middle. There you go. The little gate thingy is a platform above. Right? That mesh, that's the thing that you can walk on top of. I don't know if that's obvious.
Oh, I need to have,
I think you got it taken care of. She doesn't have to be in your party.
She doesn't have to be in my party?
I think you can just open those doors now.
All right, well.
Almost certain you can just open those doors.
Okay, now. I don't have to have share.
I'm really, 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 really certain that.
Okay.
Remember, you stole her pendant, and that's what you got arrested for. So, Chrono's got it. You served your time and broke out of jail for that pendant. All right. So, pay attention. Go click on it. To those who open the door, I am Balthazar, the Guru of Reason. I once lived in the kingdom of Zeal.
Oh, I remember that name.
A great disaster in Zeal somehow threw me into this era. To my surprise, Lavos exists here, and I suspect in other periods as well. Aeons ago, Lavos descended from the heavens. All right, come on. Burrowing deep into the world's core, he began to consume our planet's energy and grow stronger. Lavos disappeared briefly when he was summoned away by a mighty wizard who lived in Guardia in the year 600.
Oh, LaGuardia!
Yeah. In 1999, Lavos claimed this area and reigns from high atop Death Peak.
Wait, that's like 1999. Isn't that like present day?
Lavos continues to replicate like a giant parasite. He is consuming our world. Forced to live here, I continued to conduct research on Lavos, but I am growing old. And it's impossible to keep sane in such trying times. So before I lose it completely, I shall safeguard my data and my ultimate creation. How I long to return home, but I have grown frail. So you who have opened the door, I leave things in your hands. Only by mastering time itself do you stand a chance against Lavos. The odds will be against you, but you are true heroes. The world is in your hands. Ooh, epic. Open now the last door and take what you find there, my last invention.
My wings of time. So is TARDIS.
My TARDIS.
My TARDIS.
It's not exactly a TARDIS because it doesn't travel through space.
So it's a TARDIT? Time and relative dimensions.
It's more like the time machine in the time machine. It didn't move, just stayed in the same spot.
Whoa! That is so cool.
See, this is what the Untouched Gamer is all about. Seeing Leia experience this
That's for the first time.
And get that feeling that I felt the first time I played Chrono Trigger, where I'm like, oh, I'm gonna have a time machine. This is so neat. This is genuine right here.
All right. How do you get in there?
I don't know. Walk around and figure it out.
Can you get in from the front?
Well, maybe you can't get in there yet. Maybe you'll just have to leave.
Why?
I'm just saving our viewers about 20 minutes of you clicking on everything. And just go down. Try to leave. Helping you out. Just saving 20 minutes of frustration.
Thank you. You're so sweet.
Scared you, didn't I?
No, you didn't.
It's me, Balthazar!
Oh, he's Balthazar!
I copied my memory into this thing. What do you think? Anyway, there's something I need to explain. Namely, how to transcend time. Press the...
Square button for the time gauge. Mm-hmm. Use left and right to select an era. Well, yeah, before you go, why don't you... Name my time machine. Oh, man.
Alright, so this is probably going to be the next 30 minutes of the video, is if you deciding what to name this thing, and then accidentally pressing the confirm button with it randomly misspelled instead of hitting back, so best of luck with that. What are you going to name it?
I don't have enough spaces for Edward. Edward's my favorite.
What? No, you need to put a Y. No, just hit the start button. There you go. So we've named our time machine Percy.
Oh, we don't have enough spaces for Thomas or Edward or Gordon, so...
So Percy it is.
Percy it is!
Percy the time machine. which one's Percy?
The little green one.
No, but in the song, I know that Thomas is the cheeky one, and Henry huffs and toots and huffs and puffs.
Man, I can't remember what Percy does in the little song. We'll have to
ask Malachi. All right, I'm sorry. Yeah.
Instructions for the time. Okay, blah 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 blah. Press X to board and get off the device.
Okay, well, you just walk up behind him and get in the thing. The seats. Stand immediately behind the new, I think. Can't you? No? It's gotta be a control issue. Just give me this thing. No, don't hit the start button. It takes forever.
I didn't hit the start button.
Yes, you did. You hit a button as you handed me the thing. Don't do that. Okay. Yeah. Just walk to that thing and hit a button.
Cool.
Exactly what I told you to do. There you go.
Cool. So now we don't have to... All right. Apocalypse. Present.
Where did you just get kicked out of?
I just got kicked out of... I think the Middle Ages?
No.
Dark Ages?
Yeah.
Okay.
Remember, the Dark Ages is when they're having a war, and that's where he summons Lavos. Or, I mean, the Middle Ages were. The Dark Ages were where... Sorry, I misspoke. Let me start over again. Remember, the Middle Ages where they're having a war...
Well, I actually picked the right one because it's playing a cutscene.
Well, I think it would just play this cutscene anyway, because now they've got the time machine thing. Mm. I gotta keep an eye on the recording to make sure it'll actually still work.
No, it's not gonna.
Sometimes after transitioning between those.
Nope, it's still working.
Alright. Okay.
I'm glad I called it Percy. It's so funny.
Yeah. It is humorous and amusing.
Okay. Well, since I'm at the world map and something big has just happened, I should probably save it.
Yeah. Alright. Bust on back in there and show them folks who's boss. Because they kicked you out of their time zone and you're back to let them know something.
There we go. I gotta beam up to the sky.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the Elevator Show. Oh, I'm Jacob.
Come on.
This is Leia the Untouched. Oh, no, the Elevator Show's canceled.
Oh.
Elevator Show is canceled because the elevator doesn't work. Well, tough, no use. Man, the elevator doesn't work. If somebody hadn't built a ladder in a particular spot, you'd be doomed.
There's a ladder?
Somewhere around here, there's a cave with a ladder somewhere.
Oh, there's a cave right here.
I don't know if this is the cave I'm in. Maybe it is, maybe it isn't.
Surely they would set you down.
But I know, no, this is the cave that you got kicked out of.
Okay.
So you gotta go find the other cave over here. Oh, there you go, the hut. The hut.
Where?
The hut on the screen.
I don't see a hut.
Well, not anymore, because you're walking directly away from it. Walk the opposite direction of where you want to walk. Just do the opposite of what you think you should do. Nope. You didn't opposite enough.
Oh, the I hut. See a hut.
And the ladder that wasn't there before that lets you continue the game. Good thing they got on top of that ladder building contract. If that contractor hadn't come built that ladder, well, Lavos would win. That's the real hero. You know who the real hero is? The ladder builders. So this is the village of the Earthbound ones. These guys are basically the Untouchables. You know, the Enlightened ones that live up on the floating islands? Yeah, well, they're not too nice to these guys.
Let's see what these guys have to sell.
Whoa. It's really expensive, and we might not want to use it, considering the strings that it might have attached to it. Name-wise, it's like spooky. See what who are we going to use in our group? Who's our favorite characters? Because we can buy one weapon for one person, according to. I mean, you might want to sell some stuff. What is this? These poor, wretched Earthbound ones. Why do they have
I'm gonna sell that wooden sword.
Oh, that'll get. We're almost there. We can buy everything we want.
Iron blade.
Oh, there you go.
And the steel saber.
Sure.
And I keep those.
Okay.
Bronze bow.
Yeah. I mean, you can sell the tin arm and. Probably the air gun, at the very least. Definitely the bronze edge and stuff. You can sell those. The iron sword you could sell, no problem. The hide tunic you can sell. The karate gi you can sell. The bronze mail you can sell, all three of them. Hit up. There you go. What about... Yeah, you can sell that. You can sell any... How many iron suits did it say you had? Oh, yeah, three. Sell all three of those.
But some of them are wearing them. No, wait, they're not. None of them are equipped.
Sell all three. Yeah, it won't let you sell it if they're equipped. Sell all three of the, all four of the Titan's vests. Yep, go for that. Yep, liquidate those. Sell the gold suit. It's good for, is that Dagny or somebody? Okay. Don't sell the ruby vest. We might need or something. If you can sell all three of those. You can sell the bronze helm and probably the iron helm.
Yeah, one of them's equipped.
Well, no, but you can sell three of them. And one, those aren't part of that number. You have four. Trying to explain.
Beret.
Wait. Okay, I don't know if you noticed, but the beret was better for one of your guys. There was a blue number down there.
Oh.
So you sold the beret when
right.
You could have equipped it on the person. Okay, so...
But glow helms...
Well, wait. Attack is typically better than defense. Because attack ends a battle sooner. You might want to pick which three characters you will plan on having and see what kind of equipment you can get for them. And also look at who's got the lowest attack.
I think I'm probably going to end up... I really like Dagny's fire attacks, but the only problem is my best party is probably going to be Eddie, the robot man, Hank, and Cher. Then I'll have two different healers.
Well, I mean, you can do with any combination you want. I'm just saying those are the ones you want to spend money on. Don't spend money on equipment for somebody you're not going to use. Also, don't buy equipment for Eddie.
Okay.
You want to use the other five. We're fine on all that. I'm talking about you need to pick of robot, genius, frog, dits, and cat girl. Mm-hmm. You need to pick three of those and get the best weapons possible for three of those.
Okay.
Cat girl's got the best weapons. It's her fists.
Right.
So if you want to use cat girl, then you can get two weapons. But you can afford three weapons, all right. I think.
All right. I'm going to get this for her.
Okay. Okay.
And
you pretty much committed yourself to have the two girls and the robot. Okay.
Yeah.
Sounds good. Okay, get on out of here and equip. And you might have to... Because some of them aren't in your party. Right? Yeah, the girl's not in your robot. Or in your party. Robot is...
But I can still equip the,
There you go. Yeah. And then down... Yeah. Mega Blast.
Cool. I'm gonna talk to the lady.
Talk to the lady. Well. These guys are being used for slave labor. Oh, is there gonna be a pod race?
All right, that's where we came from, right?
No, the side door on the right is where you came from.
Okay, so...
You have very bad spatial memory for remembering where you came from. I think that's due to not ever playing video games like this before.
The queen put the mammon machine in the ocean palace to observe Lawless's entries that say. She locked up the guru of life. Okay, the guru of wisdom, I think. Was Balthazar.
Uh-huh.
So this is another one. Now remember them because they're named after the three traditional names of the three wise men.
All right. So who are the three gurus? The guru of life, the guru of
wisdom,
and the guru of,
I don't know, sparkles. Wisdom, light, and
make an educated guess.
Destiny.
Nope.
Justice?
Nope.
Truth?
Nope.
Wisdom.
If only it were like, obvious.
Hope.
Yeah, the guru of hope and change. Yep, sure. They look so sad.
Oh, no.
They look like guys from the future. In the, you know, the guys from the future with the seeds.
Yeah.
It looks like the same sort of models.
I can't remember what part of what part of this game that the music plays, but there's a section of music in Chrono Trigger that sounds just like the
ladder.
It sounds just like the opening to Rick Rolling song.
Hum a few bars.
The just the chords of
What? There's a save point there. Do you think that should be something you should be concerned with?
Probably.
Maybe if they put a save point there, it'll clue you in. Like, hey, you're beating me.
Yeah.
All right. Go to the right and run to that flashy thing on the bottom right. Click a button.
If I can manage to run. It's more the,
Yeah. Oh, okay. Run straight up. Run straight up. There we go. All right. Keep running. Straight up and to the left. Oh, you didn't get through them. Fight these guys.
There we go. Other metal on the line. Oh. Oh dear. I wonder if that meant my attack power's up or their attack power is up.
It definitely means that their attack power has gone up.
Okay. So maybe let's use magic on them. Because regular attacks.
So looks like his attack power goes up whenever you do anything to him. Probably the best idea would be to do the massively most amount of damage possible to one particular enemy over and over and over again so that you kill that enemy as quickly as possible without making both their attack.
There we go. I did spin cut.
And then focus as much possible attack, you know, the most powerful attacks you have on the second one. Or just lots of small attacks. We'll make sure his attack power gets as high as possible so that he hits you for the maximum amount he could possibly do. That's also something that you could do. Or you could have used your most powerful attacks on him so that he did not get his attack power up as much. Next time, strategize a little bit better. It's like, oh, they raise their attack power every time they get one of your person's dead. One of your people is dead.
Well,
in the menu and use 99 tonics. One of your people is dead means go in the menu. Oh, now you have to use a mid tonic, and that's not even going to help. Why did you use a mid tonic on the person who's not dead?
You can't use a tonic on a person that's dead.
No, she's not. She's at one. You don't die in this game. She's at one. Look, pay attention to what's going on. She's right there. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. You get almost killed in a battle, and the first thing you should do... Okay, did you just attack? Regular attack?
No, I haven't done anything yet.
Okay, well, you should use a really, really powerful attack.
I'm a spin cut.
There you go.
And then I'm gonna attack that one.
Regular attack. Not a good idea. We've established this from the very top. Regular attack, not a good idea.
Robo-tackle!
Have you forgotten how to use dual and triple techs? Or dual techs? Like, where they team up on a person? Have you forgotten how to do that? Have you forgotten that that's a thing in this game?
There we go.
The dual tech. No, down, no, no, no. You want to hit one of them. There you go. Are you hitting?
I'm hitting the same one.
Okay, you're hitting the same one.
Same one.
There you go. Heal everybody with the robo guy. The heal beam. There you go. Yeah. And now wait till she's up and fire sword him.
And then I'm going to get him. Okay. There you go.
I mean, it does make sense to you, right? That if his attack comes up every time you hit him, you need to hit him as few times as possible, which means you need to hit him as hard as possible.
Wham!
Does that not make sense? No, you're probably robo-tackle.
Robo-tackle! Boom.
There. Yay. Two hits. His attack power went up once and he never got to use it. No problemo. Your guys are at death's door. Don't move.
Hit the menu button.
Go to regular tonic and just spam regular tonic on all your guys just until he's full, until it goes bang. There you go. Tonics are like Tic Tacs. Okay? Tonics are like cough drops.
Oh my goodness.
Alright, they're color-coded for your convenience.
Okay.
Granted, you don't have water or ice person here, but take that blue one and hit him with fire sword just about as hard as you possibly can.
Okay. Fire sword.
Mm-hmm. There you go. Fire sword. The blue one. There you go. Color coded for your convenience.
Ba-doom.
Notice you hit him for 1200 and it didn't kill him? I'd just like to point that out.
Yes, I noticed that.
Okay. Fire sword him again. There you go. There you go.
Okay, and then when Hank gets filled up, I'm going to heal him. Yeah,
that's right. He went to sleep. Don't worry.
He'll still heal him, right?
Yeah, you'll be fine. You should be fine. Okay, she can go ahead and use napalm or fire, whichever one you
think. I'm gonna napalm.
Okay. Just have Hank heal.
Hank is the healer.
Hank heal.
Hank heal.
And Dagny will drop napalm on the one that she can hit for lots and lots. Oh my goodness, you've hit him for almost 4,000.
Ow.
You keep doing what you're doing. There we go, he's going to be woken up. So wait, and you'll be able to fire sword him.
Yeah.
All right. Tech, go. You are so slow. It's like a full 3 seconds after their bar is filled up before you actually hit the button. That is going to lose you some fights later on in this game if you don't learn how to go into the menu as soon as they're filled up. I'm just warning you for the future in the game. All right,
I'm watching. See? I did it.
Oh, he's asleep.
I'm gonna try.
See if fire does more than 500.
About
the same.
So as soon as Hank comes up, heal him.
Uh huh. Yeah, you're doing good.
Ah!
I saw you panic there.
I'm a fire sword him.
Yes, you are. After a whole bunch of clicking menus back and forth and panicking.
Yeah! Okay.
All right. So, what you're going to want to do is, I don't know. I don't know what fire sword would do to that thing. Probably not much, but I think you want to.
We want to heal.
Yeah, heal, and then spin cut. Maybe. What else you got? What? Just lightning him. Lightning to him. Let's see what that does. Yeah. I don't know that this is a good idea because it'll hit the little guy, but. That didn't do much good. Yeah. Mm-mm. Lightning 2 is not a good thing. Go to tech on her. Try fire sword on the big guy. I don't know what it'll do, though.
If it heals him.
Well, I mean, you haven't hit him. You haven't hit him.
It doesn't do any damage at all.
Okay. So, spin cut or lightning and robo tackle.
Let me heal robo.
Yeah, I know.
And let's do spin cut.
Yeah. You're going to have to use some ethers anyway. Same.
Okay. Measly.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, so let's use some.
If you had the other girl, you could.
Ether or mid ether?
Mid ether, you have more. On Eddie. Yeah. There you go. Alright, now you're good to go. Let's spin. Wait, no. We don't know what lightning does to him.
Lightning
1. Just on the red guy. Because that the lightning 2 was split between the two. Okay, so spin cuts more.
All right. So do you think I'm good? Can I try a robo tackle?
Yeah. I'd say you should have Hank start doing some.
Yeah, robo tackle does better.
Yeah, I know that. Okay, right. Look at her stuff and let's see what she has.
all fire stuff.
Try the Hypno Wave. I don't know if it'll get him, but we can always see. Oh, wait, did you put one asleep? Is that... Oh, he's asleep. Attack the top guy. Leave the sleeping guy alone and attack the top guy. Oh, my goodness. I think you have to attack the top... Oh, he heals every time you hit him. Never mind.
Oh,
and then he woke him up. Okay. Well, then just robo-tackle the red guy.
Robo-tackle.
And you're going to have to use a mid-ether on Hank soon, too. Yeah, the spin cut robo-tackle. Dagny can use maybe not napalm.
Well, Dagny can use her turn
to mid-ether Hank. Yeah. Yeah.
And he can spin cut.
Yeah. I think Rocket Roll is what you need to save up for. Yeah, there you go. You do go down to Rocket Roll.
Rocket Roll. No, that attacks multiple people.
Well, but I think it'll do a good amount of damage.
And
well, so just
asleep.
Well, then just do the regular Robo Tackle.
I'm gonna heal because Eddie's dropped.
It's asleep, not hurt. But all right.
All
right. Just have her do regular attack. I mean, that's the best thing she can do right now. Well, she's asleep. Have him robo tackle. Yep. But yeah, I think Dagny can just attack. Because if Hank, just heals every other turn, like robo tackle heal, if you alternate. And, you know, Dagny can shoot. Yeah. Just have him robo-attack.
Dagny's at 100.
Yeah, okay. Heal.
And then the next time I'll robo-attack.
Yeah. That probably will work. Okay, that'll wake him up. So that's actually good that he hit him. So here we go. Go combo. Yeah, wait till he's full. There we go, combo. Rocket Roll.
Rocket Roll. I don't want
to. Well, I want to see what it does. I want to see Rocket Roll and see how much damage it does.
Fine.
I'm sorry.
It's just going to heal for 150.
I'm sorry. I just want... If it did 2,000 damage, well, then you would want to know that. Now we know. Okay? So it's definitely spin cut robo tackle is what you're looking for. Goodness, where would you be without me and my, hey, you should fire swords, the blue guy, who's obviously ice-based? You wouldn't have known to do that, would you? You would have been like, oh, he's blue. I'll just regular attack, use a tonic. Every turn. Maybe when there's an enemy that the secret strategy is regular attack, sit in the menu for a while, regular attack, use a tonic, well then we'll let you decide the strategy. But,
ow.
It's fine, he's 75! It's like stubbing his toe on the door jamb or something. Just spin cut. Robo tackle and Dagny can regular attack. And if anybody gets down below 200, then when it's on Hank's turn, he can heal. Just robo tackle. Booyah. And spin cut. Come on, be quicker on these. Time's passing when you're not selecting them. That's, you're losing time to hit him. You're hitting them slower. If you select these things faster, Dagny needs to use a mid ether on it. Item, there you go. Down. Yeah. There you go. Spin cut. There you go. The game does its own sound effects. You don't need to do the sound effects.
Robo-tackle.
She's over here going, psh, psh, which is great because that's what we all did the first time we ever played this game. We would make our own little sound effects with our mouth sitting in there. You know, living room, sitting on the floor, staring up at the TV, holding the Nintendo controller. Oh, Gabby's good.
I already selected Midtonic herself.
Okay.
Good it's to just go, Hank, Hank needs to...
She can just mid... Yeah.
Hank needs to heal Spin Cut.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, get him. This is going to be tedious. Just have her attack. You're good to go. Spin cut. See, she does... Look at that! She got the final blow! Oh. Now you rock this guy's world. You are definitely going to have to use magic on it.
Okay.
Go down to Fire Sword. Yeah, Fire Sword. Yeah, there you go.
Whoosh.
I don't think Robo-Tackle will do anything. He's very resistant. Oh, it did. I thought he'd be resistant to the physical damage from it. So yeah, Fire Sword, Robo-Tackle this guy. Well, you can't Robo Tackle anymore unless you mid-Ether Hank. But Fire Sword. One more Fire Sword ought to take him out. Oh! Too bad. Mid-Ether Hank. I like how the naming convention, like, you named characters after, all your characters after characters in that book, and then you named your time machine Percy.
Well,
common theme is trains. I got you. I'm saying it works. But it is a juxtaposition of two not extremely related items.
Yeah. So.
All right, everybody. Well, I have been Jacob.
Yay!
And I have been Super.
And I have been Leia the Untouched Gamer.
And we will head on up. There's probably a save point up this chain somewhere.
Yeah.
And we're going to save it. And we will see y'all next time. So climb this chain. There you go. And there should be a save point right up at the top of it.
Yep. Just as soon as I get to a spot on a world map or something.
Yeah, there's a save point right here, I'm sure.
I don't see the save point. I don't see a save point. I thought there was going to be a save point here. Okay, everybody, sorry. We're going to keep going. Because we need to find a save point.
Yep.
So, yeah.
These guys should be really easy to do.
Should be really easy to do. You're in a new area. Lightning 2. Just lightning 2. Lightning 2. Lightning 2. Lightning 2. Trust me. Was that lightning or lightning 2?
I think I hit lightning 2. Watch.
Achoo!
Okay. Napalm. Down to napalm. There you go. Oh, it can't hit both of them. Go back out to the menu, wait for them to move around to get them where they're right next to each other, and then napalm. Laser spin. Laser spin.
There it is.
Okay, now wait. Now go to her combos. No, but go back out. They don't move when you're in the menu like that. Oh, well, there. Now wait till they get close together, and then hit the button.
Are they gonna move when I'm in this menu?
I have no idea. Well, I mean, yeah, they will, but they're not gonna move together. I don't know. Just attack them.
Just attack them again.
Zzz.
Just attack him. Just hold in the button. Just hit the A button.
Alright.
Something. Holding in the button and just attacking is a whole lot better than just sitting at the menu with your bars filled up doing nothing. Alright, well, this is going to be a longer episode.
That's yeah, go right. Up the chain.
Where's the save point? Up to the up this way to the right. Trying to remember where a save point is. Let me look.
This game doesn't have runaway, does it?
It does.
Eddie learns tech life. Cool. Oh, here's one.
Yeah, see, I knew there was one this way. Okay. I was like, I know there's one somewhere. I thought it was right immediately up the thing, but
yay,
I guess
the guru on Mount Woe.
Okay, yay. Everybody. Yeah, I have been Super and I have been Jacob. That means I have been Super Jacob. This has not been my show.
This has been my show, The Untouched Gamer with Leia. Or Leia the Untouched Gamer.
She doesn't even know what show she is on. I mean, talk about this quality content we got. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. And we will see y'all next time. Say goodnight, Leia.
Goodnight, Leia.